Hey, what's up, y'all? Well, it is time to make my my 7 college football recap, talking about this week's biggest winners and losers. So here we go. So here we go. Right, they're just gonna fall back down anyway. So here we go. So we'll start with these games that I have on my list here of games that I picked. So we'll start with this Thursday night game. We had Baylor at West Virginia, and I picked West Virginia this game. Baylor was actually a 3-point favorite. And let's see, and West Virginia won 43-40. Great game. Yeah, Western Michigan. I mean, West Virginia wins it on a last second field goal. So now Saturday, let's see. So we did have Penn State, Michigan, and Michigan. Clobbered Penn State 41-17. I mean, it was really close, for most of the way, at least in the first half anyway. I think Michigan was up like 16 to 14 at halftime, and then Penn State did kick a field goal early in the third that made it 17-16, and then after that it was just my mom all Michigan. Yeah, 25 unanswered. Michigan had a had 200 yard rushers. I think we had my mom Donovan Edwards, who had like 170 something, and then we had like 150 something to Blake Corum. I think like yeah, like my mom and Edwards actually had 10.7 yards a carry. So yeah, which is insane. So yeah, so a very dominant performance from the Wolverines. And then let's see Auburn. Oh yeah, Michigan was what was a 7-point favorite. I said that Michigan would win, but I thought Penn State would cover. I thought it would be close, but it wasn't. So anyway, so now Auburn and Ole Miss. Yeah, Ole Miss was a 15-point favorite, and I did pick Ole Miss to win and to cover the 15. They did not. Instead, they won 48-35, so that was by 14 points. And anyway, Ole Miss's offense, especially their run game, looked really good. I think they had over 300 yards rushing. So yeah, I think they had 200 yard rushers. Yes, I think they did have Zach Evans and the running back, his name Quinn Quinterio. My mom Yeah, it was Judkins. Quinn something Judkins. And then let's see. Anyway, so let's talk about Kansas and in Oklahoma. This was the end of the line for Kansas. Of course, last week they did lose to TCU. This week they lost to Oklahoma. Yeah, Oklahoma was an 8.5 point favorite, but I really thought that Kansas was gonna win because Oklahoma's defense is so trash, and I mean OU's D is still trash. I mean yeah, 42 points to Kansas with a backup quarterback. Now, of course, I am not going to blame on this loss. Yeah, I'm not going to make any excuses for Kansas about having a backup quarterback. I mean, Jason Bean, had another good game. Yeah, played good enough to win. Yeah, the problem really was for the Jayhawks was the defense, giving up 52 points. So, so Oklahoma really needed this win. I mean, OU was, is, still, fighting for survival, just to, make it to a bowl. So they just snapped a 3-game losing streak. So, well, my mom, Kansas, it was fun. Yeah, it was fun while it lasted. But anyway, but I mean, hopefully you'll at least win one more game so you can go to a bowl. But let's see. And now about Iowa State and Texas. Yes, Texas struggled against Iowa State, just like I said they would. That they just, celebrated this, 49 to nothing dismantling of Oklahoma too much. Instead of preparing for this game, they probably got, caught, overlooking Iowa State. Probably looking forward to, I believe they play Oklahoma State next. So, but anyway, so Oklahoma State or Baylor, I think they have some big opponent coming up. So Texas was a 15.5 point favorite. I did say that Texas would win, but I said Iowa State would cover, and they did. Of course, Texas only won by 3 points at 24, 21. And anyway, so yeah, so then my mom, let's look at Minnesota and Illinois. Yeah, Minnesota was a 6.5 point favorite. I thought they would win. But no, they did not. Illinois won 26-14, and yeah, and I'm done with Minnesota. I mean, I don't know what's happened to them. They were just so dominant through like the first, the first 5 weeks. They started like 5-0, and now they've lost 2 in a row. So yeah, is Illinois really the best team in I mean, yeah, is Illinois really the best team in the Big Ten West? But it doesn't matter. Whoever wins the Big Ten West is gonna get slaughtered by Ohio State or Michigan anyway. So, and then anyway, so then next, let's see, we got my mom. Let's talk about the big game of the weekend. We did have Alabama and Tennessee, and I told y'all Tennessee was gonna win. Yeah, I told y'all that was what was gonna happen, but anyway, so then yeah, so 52-49. Yeah, great game. Yeah, both teams with over 500 yards, about 1,100 total yards combined. Yeah, they came down to Alabama missing missing a game-winning field goal, you know, just like, you know, clockwork, you know, Alabama, you know, missing, you know, big kicks, you know, in gotta have it situations in a time when you have a chance to win a game, or at least, you know, tie a game, you know, go to overtime. And then, of course, Tennessee gets the ball with 21 seconds. Yeah, and they get in the field goal range and they kick the game-winning field goal. We had Chase McGrath. Yeah, of course, Will Riker did miss his kick for Alabama. So anyway, and then Jalin Hyatt, he had 200 receiving yards and like five touchdowns. I mean, that was crazy. Now we've got all this Hendon Hooker for Heisman talk. So I think that Hendon Ho has only thrown one interception, and it was in this game. So anyway, and then of course Tennessee fans, you know, stormed the field after the game was over. Yeah, and then they my mom tore the goalpost down, carried them out of the stadium, and then threw them into the Tennessee River, right outside the stadium. So anyway, a huge win for the Vols, since it was their first win against Alabama since 2006. So anyways, now about my mom. Now because of this, now there's talk that the SEC could possibly get, you know, three teams into the SEC. Of course, you got Georgia, you know, Tennessee, and Alabama. You know, there's talk that maybe they could all get in. You know, I mean, you might could maybe have, you know, you could put Ole Miss into that conversation as well. So, I mean, yeah, with Alabama losing Tennessee, you know, right now Ole Miss is in the driver's seat to win the West. So, I mean, Bama might not even make it to Atlanta. It could be Ole Miss. So, but anyway, and then yeah. So if it was Ole Miss and my mom, Tennessee, that would be I think that would be the first time that neither Georgia or Alabama has played in the SEC championship. I think probably going all the way back to 2010, to where neither Georgia or Alabama was in the SEC championship. So, but anyway, yeah, back when Auburn, South Carolina, played for the SEC championship. But, yeah, so anyway, so let's look at Oklahoma State and TCU. Oklahoma State, you know, falls, you know, no longer undefeated. TCU was a 4-point favorite. I did pick TCU to win. I also picked them to cover the 4 points, but they did not. They only won by three. Yeah, 40-43 in overtime. And so a fourth quarter comeback for TCU. I think it was 30-16 going into the fourth quarter, and then TCU with two fourth quarter touchdowns to tie the game and send it to overtime. And then, of course, TCU did win it 43-40 in double overtime. So anyway, so now about we talk. TCU remains undefeated, so I think they're now 6-0. So let's see. And the next we got NC State Syracuse. Yes, Syracuse did win, just like I thought they would. However, I thought this game would be really close. I had Syracuse favored by 3.5. I actually took NC State to cover. I thought this was going to be another close game. I mean, they've already had two wins by 3 points or less, and they beat Purdue by 3, and they beat Virginia by 2. So I thought they were going to be the cardiac cues again, but not this week though. 24-9, taking care of business against the other Wolfpack. Of course, NC State. So it was 24-9, and of course, my NC State was without their quarterback, Devin Leary. So that probably had an impact on the game. But I mean, that's not really Syracuse's problem, is it? Now, how about Arkansas and BYU? Yes, Arkansas did beat BYU 52-35. Now BYU was a 1-point favorite, and I did take Arkansas to win. So anyway, so 52-35, and Raheem Sanders had a good game. I think he had like 173 yards, something like that. It was a lot, and like 2 touchdowns. He was getting like 11 yards a carry. So yeah, for Raheem Rocket Sanders, yeah. And then I mean KJ Jefferson, yeah, looking like CJ Stroud, yeah, with 5 touchdown passes. So and then how about so a big win for Arkansas. They really needed this. Yes, snapping a 3-game losing streak. So about and then here we had James Madison, who was undefeated, and they were ranked. Yes, 25 in the AP, 22 in my poll. Yeah, and they were an FCS team last year. It's their first year in FBS. So anyway, so they did start 5-0 and were ranked in the top 25. But of course, then they did lose to Georgia Southern. So they are no longer, no longer undefeated. Now they're like 5-1. So, so 45-38, and James Madison was a 12.5-point favorite. So, I thought they would cover that, but they didn't. So. Anyway, yes, and then my mom, and then Georgia Southern had over 500 yards passing, which is crazy, considering that my mom Georgia Southern had been running the triple option for years. So I think for decades, even kind of like my mom Georgia Tech, although Southern has seemed to have had a much better transition away from the triple option. So Anyways, I was looking at LSU in Florida. Florida's 2.5-point favorite. I thought LSU would win. They did not. Instead, LSU wins. It was 45-35. I mean, Florida actually made my mom Jaden Daniels looked like he knows what he's doing. So anyway, there's an ending, of course, about my mom. Yeah, so now the morning shoe is going to stay the morning shoe for at least another year until Florida can beat LSU. So anyway, so how about next? Clemson, Florida State. Clemson was 33.5-point favorite. They did win and cover that, like I said. It was 34-28. Yep. You let the Taters did let the Noles come back in this game. I think it was like 34-14. And so then 2 fourth quarter touchdowns by FSU, and then did come down to an onside kick, which Clemson recovered. So anyways, now about my mom. Mississippi State, losing to Kentucky at 27-17. Mississippi State was 4-point favorite, and I did pick them in this game. It didn't work out. So, yes, so Kentucky did get Will Levis back, and it did make a big difference over just the 14-point game. Against only the 14 points that they had scored against South Carolina. So yeah, now 27-17. Mississippi State now with their second loss. I think that Kentucky and Mississippi State both 5-2 now. Anyway, so now let's talk about this game here. This game came on 8:00. Southern Cal and Utah. Utah was 3.5-point favorite. I did take Utah to win and to cover the 3.5. They did not. Instead, they only won by one. Yeah, 42-43. Yeah, this was a great game. It came down to a 2-point conversion at the end, and Utah got it and won it in regulation, 43-42. So, but anyway, let's talk about some games. Not on my list, of course. Of course, Georgia just absolutely obliterated Vanderbilt. 55-0. So, which is what you know the number one team should do. So, but anyway, so Stetson Bennett actually threw two touchdown passes. So I think he had gone what, like, the last three games without a touchdown pass. So anyway, another exciting game. So let's see North Carolina beat Duke 38-35. Yeah, that was a good game. So a fourth quarter comeback by North Carolina. I think they did score to go up by four. It was 38-34, and then we were able to hold off Duke. So let's see Oregon State beat Washington State 24-10. Yeah, Oregon State is now quietly 5-2. So, seeing a significant game. Yeah, how about let's look at some bottom 10 teams. How about Hawaii? Beat Nevada 31-16. Yes, Hawaii gets their first FBS win of the season. And New Mexico State also won Saturday. And they beat New Mexico 21-9. So Fresno State San Jose State to get their first FBS win. Yeah, I forgot what the score was, but let's see more group of fives. Coastal Carolina no longer undefeated. They fell to Old Dominion 49-21. UCF annihilated Temple 70-13. Yeah, UCF scored 70 points on Temple. Yeah, I still don't know how they lost to Louisville. So, let's see anything else big. Colorado. Yeah, got a win. Yes, Colorado got a win. Yes, they beat California. So, yeah, California, Berkeley. I think it was like 30-17, something like that. Yeah. So anyway, yes, that's obviously a big win for Colorado. Yes, that was actually their first win. So, I think that this has gone on long enough. So, thanks for watching if you've made it this far, and I'll see y'all again next time.